Good morning, everyone. We are continuing here in the words of the Horowitz in the Sefer Mitzvahs, and we're starting today a new mitzvah, Mitzvah Yud-Dalet, number 14. Mitzvahs ase, a positive commandment, Lilmoi Torah, to learn Torah, Ulalamda, and to teach it as well. This is deraisa, this is based on verses that we're going to find in the Torah, which means a person has an obligation to learn Torah every single day, as we're going to see. Shenemar, like it says in the Torah, Veshinantom Levanecha. You need to teach the words of Torah diligently, Levanecha, to your children. Mitzvah Shiudivei Torah Mechudadim Befiv. There is a mitzvah that the words of Torah should be sharp in Befiv Shel Adam, in the mouth of a person, which means they should be clear. You should know what you are saying. Shelo yigam game b'hem, in order that you don't stumble or stammer over the words of Torah that you are learning and that eventually you're going to teach. If there is a mitzvah to teach them the shinantam levanecha, diligently, to your children, how can you teach them to your children if you don't know the words of Torah themselves? And therefore your preparation to be able to teach them in the right way is to learn it in the proper way as well. Bein ani or bein asher, whether you are a poor man, or bein asher, or you are a rich man. So if you're poor, you could come up with all the excuses. I have no money, I'm going around panhandling from place to place, I have a lot of stress and worries on my head, trying to figure out how I'm going to pay the bills this month. Who has time to learn? If I'm an asher, if I'm a rich man, so I'm busy counting my money, I'm busy with the bank, funneling money into another bank account, I've got property that I have to go and manage and look over. I have a business that has 115 employees. I've gotten responsible for all of their paychecks. I have to make sure that at the end of the month, everything is working in order. I don't have time. Says the Chofetz Chaim, you have to make time because that's the obligation. Bachar v'zaken, whether you are a bachar, whether you are a young man, or a zaken, or you're an old man. If you're young, you'll say, I've got so much going on. I have a whole life ahead of me. Let me take advantage of my youth right now. I'll live it up a little bit. I'll have fun. I'll enjoy. I'll hang out with my friends. I'll go to fun places and do exciting things. Well, I'm the zaken. I'm the old man. I don't have to. How can I learn? I'm groggy. I'm tired. My body is aching. My mind doesn't work the way that it used to. No, says the Chofetz Chaim. Whether you're young or old, you have an obligation. Ubal yisurim. What about a person who is a Baal Yisurim, who is filled with suffering in his life, whether it be physical, whether it be emotional, whether it be biological, physiological, whether it be psychological, whether it be financial, no matter what the situation, says the Chofetz Chaim, whatever you are going through, whatever challenges and difficulties you have in life, there's still an obligation to learn. Even a poor man that is so poor, he has to go around knocking on door to door to make a few pennies to be able to buy himself some food. He's standing at the edge of the freeway in California. He's living in a tent underneath the over ramps, the overpass. He's still umach al psachim. He has to go and beg for money. Chayev ligboya laizman latoro bayom ubalayla. He has an obligation to affix for himself time for learning in the day and the night. Shenemar, like it says in the verse, famously, a person must meditate and be engaged in the learning of Torah day and night. And furthermore, a person has an obligation to learn until the end of their life, the day of death. Be careful, says the Torah. The words of Torah should never depart from your heart. All the days of your life, which means even while a person is in their final moments, in their final days of life, Rachman al-Etzlan, we should not know this till 120 years. Even in the very end, a person has an obligation to be learning the most amazing and wonderful and incredible Das Elokis, the wisdom of Hashem ever, and that is the Torah HaKadosha, which HaKadosh Baruch has bequeathed to his treasured nation, the Klal Yisrael. Much more to say about Limud HaTorah. We shall continue that Be'ezus Hashem tomorrow. All the best.